the exceeding, oh my God, that we may know the exceeding greatness of his power. Engage it. Encounter the power, the exceeding greatness of his power. Because let's find out something about this power that we need to know. To us, Lord, who believe, what is his power? He just got power. Huh? God, he got all the power you need. God is powerful. God is powerful. Don't stop there. His power is toward us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power. You get this, Mario? God's power is toward them that are believing. All you do, believing, power towards you. It's right there. I didn't make this up. You can't go around making up stuff. You can't make up stuff like this. If you just go make up something, you can't have a Bible to read it. People say, oh, he are way off on the deep end. But here it is, right here. God's power is toward us who believe. May you encounter it this week. May you engage the power of God. I don't care what situation you get in this week. You tell God, your power is toward me who believes. Your power is toward me because I believe. Your power is toward me because I believe. Now, watch this. It's Resurrection Sunday. We get to it. I got my Easter. So, which he wrought in Christ. He says now, the greatest demonstration of my power was wrought in Christ. When what? When he raised him. Now that same power that raised him from the dead is toward us who believe. Amen. It's resurrection power. You got anything need to be resurrected? Huh? You tired of walking around dead stuff? You tired of dead stuff? You know, Buzzard, you was ordained an eagle. Amen. Eagle like fresh food. Buzzards that stick around dead stuff. Come on back. They said, Lazarus, don't worry. Don't trouble the master. Lazarus gone. Why'd you wait? Martha said, what the world did you wait? 4 days, you know. You know, they will wait 3 days. They actually, when you die, they believe that you was coming back to life anyway. So they make sure you was dead. Is he really dead? Check 1 day. Check 2 days. Check 3. They didn't believe you were dead till you were dead. You'd be dead, but anyway. 3 days. Now 4 days is really bad. If you, number one, if you had been here, my brother wouldn't have died. When we called for you and told you that Lazarus was sick, you should have dropped whatever it was that you were doing and got over here. Jesus waited on purpose. He waited till they could go and observe for 3 days, and the fourth day, they said, oh. He said, Lazarus, sleep. But you know, you're dealing with earth people that don't have no revelation and wisdom and eyes of understanding life, they say he had to plainly tell him, he dead. Okay, he said, but I'm going to raise him up. He got there, they got this tomb all put together. Now, what did Jesus do? He gave thanks. Here's what he did. The Bible says he groaned in the spirit. He prayed in the Holy Ghost. After he finished praying in tongues, he said, I give you thanks. Because you hear me, and that you hear me always. He said, but for the sake of these folks standing around here that don't believe, he said, we finna bring him on out of here. He said, roll that stone out of there. They rolled the stone away, and he said, Lazarus, come forth. This is that same power that raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in heavenly places,
right,
far above all principality and power and might and dominion, every name that is. But that power is toward who?
Us.
Who do what?
Believe.
The power is toward us who believe. Us who believe. The greatest demonstration of that power was when he raised Jesus from the dead.
Right.
They knew he was dead. Because they said they usually had a tradition where they break a bone. And they went to break his bone, but they didn't do it because he was dead already. So the scripture would be fulfilled, now the bone in his body was broken. I wonder how they got that big chisel up through the hand and didn't break no bone. That's a miracle in itself, right? They didn't break no bone. How you get that thing through your feet? This was chisels. They nailed you to the cross and not one bone get broke. Huh? You know when you study, show you the bones, all the bones in the body? How in the world could you get a big old spike through somebody's feet and not one bone get broke? How did it get to his hand and not one bone get broke? How could you hang him up there and his weight drop down from hanging in there and not one bone get broke? Man, he died. Jesus died. To the son refused. The son said, no, two sons can't shine at one time. It was the moon started bleeding. Started dripping out of blood. The dead in the city. The dead got up and started walking the streets of the city. My God, it was a whole lot of shaking going. It got pitch black dark out there. My God. But the Bible said it pleased the Lord to bruise him. He laid on him the iniquity of us all. And then he brings us into this New Testament church. And that same power is toward us who believe. My God, engage it. Have an encounter. Won't you just sit, you can sit right there. Just lift your head. Encounter it right now. Engage that power right now. I'm talking about resurrection power. Engage it right now. Take it. Take it. Receive it. Tell the Lord, I receive it. I believe it. I believe it. I receive it. It's mine. Glory to God. That power, if he said it's toward us, glory to God, engage it. Have an encounter with it.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hey, Shikolamandalabas.
Hallelujah.
Keep an arm up, Toko. You wrought it in
Hallelujah.
Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.
When you raised him from the dead, set him at your own right hand. Far above every principality, every power, every name that is named. Not only in this world, but also in that which is to come. Hey, the power is toward us who believe. Your power is toward us who believe. Your power, every believer, Father God, let him encounter your power. Your power, let him encounter.
Thank you, God.
We engage our heart with thanksgiving and a voice of Mary. Hallelujah, Father God.
Hallelujah.
He brought it in Christ when he raised him from the dead.
Yes.
Father, we give you glory.
Thank you.
We give you thanks. In Jesus' mighty name.
Yes, Father.
Glory.
Hallelujah. Let me get a good amen for you.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Good word.
Amen. Glory to God. Beautiful.
You don't have to make up prayers. It's a prayer right there in Ephesians 1. And you can pray that, Lord. Always gonna need all of those things every day. Wisdom for the day. We engage our heart in thanksgiving. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Can I get a good amen?
Amen.
Thank you. Anybody got any testimonies? Just give them the thanks.
It's not on that.
Oh, no.
You would go there.
Wait, wait, wait.
Okay. Well, I ain't going there.
All right.
Now, you said something earlier today, and I had forgot all about this, but it made me think about it when you was giving us the sermons, and I believe it has something to do with, something about angels. And what it reminded me of, I guess it's about 2 or 3 weeks ago, one day, a lady came over to my apartment complex. Mm-hmm. And I see this lady outside, and she walking around looking like she lost. And she had a band on her arm, like she just, had, I guess, got to the hospital or something, but it was a red band. And I'm inclined to maybe believe she might have been maybe escaping the nut house, I don't know. But this is what was peculiar. I see this lady walking around. She walked around doing like this. You know, I'm looking at her through my front door. I'm like, what is going on with her? And she keeps on walking around, looking around like that. Then finally, she walked somewhere like back towards where I'm at. And I'm looking at her through my door. And she just standing around there looking. Then she looks at me. And I look at her. And she's still just standing there doing like this. And she see me, you know, look at me. And she just standing there like this. And I'm like, what is going on, right? So then she finally walks over towards the door where I'm at, and she said, I'm looking for, I said, what's going on, what you want? She said, I'm looking for a place to lay my head, you know, a shelter or something. She said, I know it's not a shelter. And I told her, I said, well, no, this is not a shelter, and I really don't know, you know, where no shelters are. And she's still walking around looking like this, and she said, well, I'm looking for a place to lay my head. So I said to the lady, I said, well, this is not a shelter, you know, and you can't do that here, you know. And the lady looked at me and walked towards the door. I'm on one side, she on the other. And she said, well, I'm just looking for a place to lay my head. She said, if you don't want me here, I'm looking for a place to lay my head. If you don't want me here, she said, don't send your angels after me. And I'm looking at her, and she said it again. And she say, if you all don't want me here, I'm just looking for a place to lay my head. She say, don't send your angels after me. And I looked at her, and I'm thinking to myself, what do you, you know? I didn't really know. But it was strange to me, because I got to thinking afterwards, you know, that maybe sometimes other people in the spirit see things in the spirit that we don't see. Because I was wondering, why are you saying, number one, it's like she recognized I got angels that I can send behind her or something. And I'm not looking at the angels. And I'm like, what? I don't know what you know, whatever. And I walked outside a few minutes later, about 5 minutes later, just to curious to see where she went, you know. And I went out there, there was a police car out there. I don't see her. I go and look up and down, she don't see her nowhere. I see the police on the phone. I can't see who in the vehicle, and he leaves. I just felt that was kind of strange. I don't really totally understand it. You know, I don't know if the spirit give you some utterance, whatever. I mean, that was strange to me. Because I feel like sometimes there's things that happen in the spirit that we don't recognize, and some other people see it. And in that case, that could even be part of a demonic spirit. But whatever that spirit was, it recognized, I'm assuming, that I had some angels that could do something to it. That's my little testimony. Somewhere.
That's a good one.
Now, I didn't think about it until when you said what you said today, because I had forgot all about it.
Absolutely.
And I just felt it was something peculiar to share.
That's a
somebody good one. Might get some out of it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I did. Mm-hmm. Sometimes demons know we got more angels than we know.
Yes.
I got that.
I believe it.
So now you know. You got some angels.
Yeah, but I was like, she was like, and she said it twice.
Well, put the angels to work.
That's what she said. She said, don't send your angels after me. And she acted like she was serious. Like she was concerned, like, you send your angels after me, something gonna happen to her or something.
Well, work your angels.
Praise God.
They with you.
Praise God.
Amen. Amen. Work. In the name of Jesus, amen. Everybody, go in peace and return with testimony.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Glory to God. It's not just a benediction, that's a blessing. It will happen.
Amen.
Glory to God. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.